So now our next task is to get internet access through the ISP over here. Because you can see we still cannot ping 8888 and we need a way to get to the ISP. So we're going to connect R1 core G40 to the ISP and our R1 core. We're going to do interface G40 IP address. We're just going to do DHCP. So it should get an IP address from the outside world, from my ISP. So if you do show IP int brief, and G40 is currently down, so no shut. And we should see that it should get an IP address and assigned. There we go. So now it has an IP address. And first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a default route. So that would be IP route 0000000 to exit interface G40. Okay, now if we do show IP route, now this router knows how to get to the internet through G40. And we need to now advertise this default route to the rest of our network so that they also know how to get to the internet. We'll do router OSPF 1 default information originate. Before we enter this command, we're just gonna go to switch 2 and we're gonna type do show IP route. As you can see, it doesn't have a default route yet. So it doesn't actually have a route to anywhere other than our internal network. And when we enter this command, and now if we do show IP route, it knows how to get to network anything via 192.168.1.2, and you can see that it learned its route from this line. So every router on our OSPF area, OSPF domain, now knows how to get to the internet via G40. But that's not done yet because we still need to configure network address translation. So in R1 core, we're going to make an access list. So that would be access list, let's just say 10. And we're going to permit, just for the purpose of this lab, we're going to permit all of our internal networks. So that would be permit 10.0.0.0 and 0.255.255.255. And then we're going to do IPNet inside source list 10. Which is our access list 10 here. And we're going to do interface G40, which is this interface over here. And we're going to do port address translation, so we're going to do overload. Enter. And we're going to specify our outside and inside interfaces. So interface G40, IPNet outside, and interface range G30, G20. IPNet inside. Okay, so if we do show IPNet translations, you can see that there's no entry yet. Okay, so after I typed show IPNet translations, you can see that nothing has been translated yet. And I actually just made a minor change in the topology. I took out the NAT cloud because the NAT cloud is not working for me at the moment on my VM. So we're just going to simulate an internet connection using another router. So before we move on, we're just going to interface G40 and we're going to make an actual address and we're going to simulate a public IP address, so 200.100.100.1.255.255.255.252. And show IP int brief. Okay, and then we're going into the ISP router. Conf t interface G40 IP address. It's going to be in the same subnet as this, so R1 200.100.100.2 and /30 no shut. And in the loopback interface, we're going to create IP address 8888 to simulate Google's DNS server, and we're going to create an IP route through G40 so that the ISP knows how to get back. Okay, so now when we go back to R1 core and we type show IP NAT trans, you can see that there's still no NAT translations. And if we go to PC1 now, 10.1.10.10 from the DHCP server, and if we try to ping 8888, as you can see, PC1 is able to access its default gateway into R1 core, and R1 core's default route and NAT translations all the way to the ISP, and from ISP all the way back to 10. And if we look back at our router, show IP NAT translations, now you can see that our inside IP address of 10.1.10.10 has been translated to 200.100.100.1 on port 29, since we're using port address translation. So that concludes this entire topology.